All right, well, we're happy to have Bob Adamson, a realtor with McInerney Associates in Arlington, here with us today. Bob, you're an RPAC trustee, you're an RPAC campaign co-chair, so you're very familiar with how members' investments in RPAC get used. So can you tell us a little bit about where that money goes?
I sure can, Lisa. We spend the RPAC dollars in a number of ways, the main way being direct contributions to candidates. So who we interview or we track, and then we decide who to give money to. But that's only one of the ways. We also get involved in campaigns. We'll do direct emails. We'll do some direct postcard mailings. We do get out the vote efforts on campaigns where we really have a candidate that we'd like to see win that election. In addition, there's something called issues mobilization. So if there's a specific issue that we want to fight or support, whether it's at the national level, like a mortgage interest deduction, or the state level, or even at the local level, a zoning issue of some kind, we can have dollars that we can put into the fight to educate people and get the right result.
I see. Well, RPAC is doing a lot of great work. So how do you, as RPAC trustees, decide who to support?
Well, it's kind of a complicated process, but the main thing we do is we look at the legislators' voting records and what committees they're on, et cetera, and we see how they voted on our issues particularly, and we decide based on that and their ability to be in tune with our issues that if we're going to support them, and if we do support them, to what extent we support them. In addition, there's open seats oftentimes, and we'll send out questionnaires to candidates who are running for those seats, and then bring them in for the interviews. And that's kind of an interesting process, because during that process we get to educate them about what realtor concerns are, what our issues are, why we have those stands on those issues. So at the same time we're deciding which of them might best suit our realtor community needs as an elected official, we're educating them about what the best policies are from a realtor perspective.
So if someone were to have an issue with a candidate that you supported or don't like support of a particular political party, how would you address that issue?
Well, Lisa, first I would say we really don't play party politics at all. Despite what some of the members may sometimes think, we don't wear an R Republican or D Democrat hat when we're acting as RPAC trustees. We interview the candidates, we look at their voting records in a very objective manner, and we try to do what's best and pick the people who are best for the realtor community, for our clients and constituents, the homeowners, and for our communities in general. So we wear the big R Realtor Party hat, and we do our best to do what's right for the community.
Very good. So how have you viewed your RPAC investment? How has that paid off for you?
Well, I've been fortunate over my career, especially in the last 12 years or so, to attend NVAR's bus trip to Richmond. I've gotten involved with the legislators down there. I've sat in on committee and subcommittee meetings. I've gone to the Realtor Day on the Hill with the Virginia Association of Realtors. So I've seen the legislation being worked on. I've watched our bills, our realtor bills, get carried through and pass. I've seen some go down in flames, but you know, it's been an opportunity to really see our dollars in action working for legislation that is realtor friendly. In addition, we attend local county board, city council meetings, so we're watching what's going on at the local level in terms of zoning, unusual rules, oftentimes things we have to fight, not things we're supporting so much, to protect our business and our clients and customers.
Well, that's a lot of great information for anyone looking to invest in RPAC. But should someone have additional questions, where can they turn?
Well, there's plenty of resources. I would start right here at NVAR. We have the best government affairs staff you could have, with Mary Beth Coya and Lisa May. They are just well-versed in everything, every aspect of policy from the realtors and local and state and national politics. You've got myself and Virgil Frizzell, who run the RPAC campaign. You've got John Wolford and the entire board of directors. We've got lots of people, so we encourage you to talk to us, to get involved, and come join in the process. The more the merrier.
Absolutely. Well, thank you, Bob, very much.
Thank you.